And here today, we're going to basically launch a really exciting competition to basically, hopefully, mobilize youth around the world behind a good deal in Paris in December. I'm Nick Nuttall. I'm the spokesperson for the UNFCCC, as we like to call it. And I'm going to hand over now to Miro, who's going to explain what the competition's all about. Thanks, Miro.
So, dear young people who will see this video in the weeks and months ahead, welcome to this launch of the 2015 Global Challenges Youth Music Contest. So, some information why we are doing this. Of course, this is a unique year that we have now with this post-2015 agenda and COP21 negotiations. But in order to make this really work, we need everybody on board. We need a lot of social energy. We need people to understand what the United Nations system is doing. And here music can play a great role and really getting everybody on board. Music is the universal language of humanity. It builds bridges between the hearts and minds of the people, and it inspires action. And therefore, COP21 is a good place to start a new journey of humanity based on music and youth engagement. Our slogan is, let the music talk, let the rhythm play, let the world know what the youth have to say. It aims to engage young people in global challenges action in the context of goals and programs of United Nations systems through music, youth-focused narratives, and innovative media partnerships. And by offering a COP21 Global Youth Music Contest Award this year, we want to provide a particular support to the work of the UNFCCC and getting the momentum that COP21 will be a big success. The organizers of the competitions are UNESCO Management of Social Transformation Program and my organization, the International Association for the Advancement of Innovative Approaches to Global Challenges, in cooperation with UNFCCC Secretariat, Article 6. And then we have partners also in New York, because it's important that we build conceptual bridges also between the post-2015 Sustainable Development Agenda and climate change. We have also media partners as important partners. We are working with the European Broadcasting Union, and we have also additional partners who are working on local COP 2015 action, like the Citizens Climate Lobby, and also with the organizers of Youth Conference on Youth. There are two components. One is the online competition, global online competition, and the other component is the TV show in December. I would like to show you how a music clip could look like that we have in mind when calling for this.
If we don't make the changes, and that's just some of what's to come in unexpected rains. But it's not all just doom and gloom, there's something to be done here. The young, the old, the hot, the cold, we all got our reasons, yeah. We rap, we call, we march, we sing, we're gonna try our hardest to get our leaders to hear our calls and commit to binding targets. 350, yeah, 350. That's the same level, but above that,
This was an example, a submission that we've received in 2009 ahead of the COP15 in cooperation with 350.org. We organized their very small competition.
Thanks very much for outlining the plans for this music competition, which sounds really exciting. I'm going to go over to my colleague here, and if you can give us a little bit of a brief assessment of how you're involved and how you see this competition. Thanks.
Sure. So I'm Joe Robertson. I'm the Global Strategy Director for Citizens Climate Lobby, and we have something called the Pathway to Paris Project. So this is an effort to do what we do in local communities around the world, engaging citizens in policy. And part of what we're trying to do for Paris is bring people from around the world into what we call work stream teams. There's going to be a lot of information flowing back and forth, reporting out from the COP and reporting in from the rest of the world, so that the landscape of information is actually being shaped by people from everywhere. One of the things that we see in this contest as so important is that there's an opportunity to introduce people around the world, especially young people, to the importance of the COP21, the importance of the UNFCCC process, and to opportunities for leadership and action going forward. What we see as a great opportunity in terms of the media availability, the visibility of this event, and the creative energy going into it from young people everywhere around the world, is that out of that comes mobilization. And the mobilization isn't just for education and awareness, it's for empowerment and action. Getting people engaged with each other, getting them engaged with the political process itself, and actually beginning to give them a role. And what we would like to see is when Citizens Climate Engagement Network is launched, also during the COP21, and then begins to work around the world, you see opportunities for young people to actually mobilize by getting directly involved in science, education, policy, innovation, and supporting the ongoing political process.
We have our youth representative here. How does this all fit in with your plans and what you're up to in the run-up to COP21 in Paris?
Well, we imagine an event where we can discuss about climate change, not only for a scientific or negotiation perspective, but also from an artistic activist perspective. And we also imagine a gathering of young people that will happen not only in Paris, such as COP21, but that will happen all over the world. And that will comes with the message that youth is obviously everywhere, and to really have an inclusive message and inclusive process, we have to come to these people and not only expect them to come. We also imagine an event so that will happen on the five continents simultaneously. And this, to achieve the goal of involving, have more people involved in the process and to be able to tackle these issues from different perspectives. So ranging from people who more or less never heard about climate change or didn't have the time or the money to dedicate to this to climate experts. And how do we achieve this gathering, this inclusive process? We have three axes of proposition and mobilization. The first one is to organize local events. So COI, the 11th Conference of Youth, which is the event we are planning from the 26th to the 28th of November 2015 in Paris area, will also happen and all over the world. And we want to make sure that these events are not only broadcasted one way, and our second axis of mobilization to make sure that we share resources, which means that one speaker at some part of the world can exchange his message and ideas with all the local events. And this sharing of resources allows underprivileged areas or people who don't have the funding to have key speakers to come to benefit from the anything we can expect from a good internet connection. And the third axis of mobilization is to come with an attractive and innovative program. And this is where I believe music comes in, because we music has always been the way to engage people into social causes for the couple of decades, I would say. And as you said it very well, Miro, it carries the message without the words, and it never needs translation. Music should also carry the message that the youth generation has something to do with climate change adaptation and mitigation, and in that way, we should reach out more people and bring awareness to that. And on the Conference of Youth side, we believe that having local events will allow us to organize the so-called GYCMX, or an independently organized youth music contest. And in that case, we will benefit from the diversity that comes from events located all around the world. And maybe, I don't know, this could bring a little bit of diversity in our Western music style.
Well, thanks very much indeed. So as you say, we're here today to launch this this competition. We need all young people around the world to basically get their guitars out, get the pianos out, get whatever musical instrument you want to get out, or if you just want to rap, that's fine without music, whatever you want to do, but make a contribution to this competition. At the UN Framework Convention on Climate Change, we're already running something called Climate Song of the Week, and we'd be happy to profile some of these songs coming through as one of our weekly hits. And above all, while it's about climate change, while it's about some of the big issues in the world, it's also about having fun. So, you know, climate change can be fun, and this is a living example of it. By tackling it, you can change the world, and also maybe you can win a trip to Paris.
Yes, exactly.
Excellent. Okay, thank you very much.